let's see how his day will start. Russia. Lukasz Kofalik. He's up against Alexander Vachavyak. Now I have it. Of Belarus. Belarus, yeah. Mm-hmm. He got his shoulders are big enough to wear that title. Kropalek. If you see, I mean, this is heavyweight, you know how athletic they are. It is incredible.
I wonder what I wonder what height he is. He must be about 6. What's the thing? About 6.
You will find it out.
Yeah, we'll find out.
We'll find it out.
And he's have a visit as well. Warm up. Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, the size of a door, I would say.
Yeah.
About the size of a door.
And still, you see a difference when it comes up to Teddy Riner. Then everything seems little.
Yeah.
And smaller. Yeah, but it's really perfect athlete size. No, looking there for the counter.
Yes.
Yeah, just took his hands.
Now looking for the new Azza.
Yeah.
Opening.
I mean, with his skills, Lukasz got not a determined grip. His left arm, look at his left arm, it's under the shoulder from the Belarusian.
Yes.
It should be right in front, behind the neck, or in the neck, behind the head. Again, okay, maybe he prefers that to get a little bit closer, to get more contact, his left arm there on the back. But he's not that upright. He would be with another grip.
Yes.
But okay.
But yeah. And I suppose if you don't get that rotation, you leave your shoulder behind.
As we just saw. Yeah. And that was more difficult, I think, than just to take the head with you and then
Have
the shoulder with you and also your opponent. Right. We also had a nice story, Meet the Champions with Lukasz, and it was a pleasure for me to visit him, where he lived, together with his really beautiful wife. And at that time, he had one kid, now he got two beautiful kids. Daddy. Kids are watching, for sure. And his wife, keeping the fingers crossed. For sure, they don't see him much.
Oh.
You know, in all the competition, training camps, and he's, as everybody,
he'll be incredibly busy,
looking forward maybe some big holidays after Tokyo. Spend time with husband and daddy. Slowed down a little bit.
Mm.
Both are pushing. It doesn't look that good. Need to get a little bit more, the look more convincing.
Yeah. Yeah, it is a slow start, isn't it? And probably just maybe being a little bit wary. Maybe have a look at the head-to-head zone.
Yeah, Vahavia is making a good job.
Yeah,
I mean,
really
that's the answer to it. He makes it hard for Krapalek. The last minute here, single penalty for Krapalek. Attacking on the outside, a little bit too far away. Nemanja Majdor from mat number three is coming there onto the it's coming now onto the mat. Former world champion against the German. So Julia, for sure you keep your fingers crossed now at home. Julia and Eddie.
Well, that is interesting, a head-to-heads.
Yeah.
Krapalek fought him at the Grand Slam in Tel Aviv just this year and lost.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so
this
head-to-heads.
Year?
Yeah. 1-1 on the head-to-heads.
It's not that long time ago.
No. So maybe just being that overcautious, looking to come round the legs. That was nicely passed. Yeah, just controlling underneath.
And he is good in Nevaza.
On the hip.
And if you realize, okay, Tashevaza is a little bit difficult or some attacks are maybe a little bit dangerous, then just solve it. You said take that chance on the ground.
Yeah.
And he did.
Yeah, nicely done there by Lukas Krapalek. He'll go through now to, is it the third round or is it quarter final where he'll go through?
Oh, sorry.
Quarter final now.
Well, you know what? I would like to have a look down on mat number three with a former world champion, Nemanja Majdor.